What's going on, everybody? Today I have a 2016 Ford F250 with a 6.2 liter in it. Customer complained of the check engine light on and the AC was blowing warm. AC was blowing warm because it was in limp mode. The code was a P0355, which is circuit E injector fault, whatever, or not injector, but a coil. So a spark plug is not going to cause that, and the wire is not going to cause that. You want to look for an electrical issue on from the coil to the harness side. So I ohmed out the coil. Coil is good. It ohmed out at 1.4. It's supposed to be between 0.5 and 2.0. Coil is good. Check for power from the connector to battery negative. Anything less than 10.5 volts, you got to open or short to power. And it had 12.5 on it. Same thing with the ground side, checking for a short to ground. All that passed. So I found a TSB on it for the coil driver and the PCM. It needed a PCM update. So I reprogrammed the PCM with my scan tool, and it's running fine now, but I'm gonna show you a power balance test. I'll show you how to do this. So with my scan tool here, we're gonna go special functions, power balance, okay. And then it's gonna communicate and all that good stuff. And you can see it's cylinder five is this one. It's running dead on, it's smooth. So there's no misfires going on. Now I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna do misfire test. It's gonna be running. Make sure you got the key to on, engine off, start the engine, press the OK button. We're gonna press OK. And P0355 is cylinder number five. So we're gonna look at cylinder number five, which is right here. Cylinder number five, and as you can see, there's no misfires. So if you have the ability, if you have an IDS, which is integrated diagnostic software for Ford, if you have that, or if you have a scan tool like this one I'm using here, then you can actually go through and look at PIDs to, and then you can do the power balance, you can clear the codes, I mean, you can do all that stuff. It's two-way. Like I said, I found that TSB and I reprogrammed the powertrain control module and it fixed the problem. A lot of people will just throw spark plugs and a coil on it and it comes right back within 100 miles. So that's not actually fixing the problem. The problem is the driver software inside the PCM for that specific coil. So like I said, first you're going to check, you're going to ohm out your coil between 0.5 and 2 is what you need. Then you're going to check for power on the connector side to battery negative, and then you're gonna check for ground at the same time. And you can also do a spark tester as well. It may be an intermittent problem, like it doesn't do it all the time. So that actually ended up being the case in this one. It was just the driver software update. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and thank you.